Hi YouTube, this is Michigan Snow Pony, or Renee, and I'm not really doing a garden update right now. I want to talk about a product. I've been visiting a lot of gardening channels, and everybody seems to be complaining, or a lot of people seem to be complaining, about cabbage worms on their cabbage crops, like broccoli and cauliflower and Brussels sprouts. And so I keep leaving the same comment over and over about what to use, and I thought, well, I'm going to do a video about it. I've used the same product for years. In fact, the very first time I used it was 30 years ago on my little garden that I had in high school, a little 12 by 10 foot plot, and that's when I discovered it. And for all of you that garden organically, it's organic. What you're going to be doing is putting on a disease of the cabbage worm. It's I thought it was a virus, but it's actually either a fungus or a bacterium. And you buy this something with Bacillus thuringiensis, or BT, and I'm probably not saying that the correct way, but anything with BT in it, and you mix this concentrate with water, spray it on your plants. The little caterpillars come along and munch on your plants. It takes about a day or so, then they turn black, fall off, and die, and you're done with them. So if you see those little white moths or butterflies flying around your cabbage plants, you're probably going to have a caterpillar problem soon. And a lot of people say, well, I look at my plants and I don't see anything. Well, you've got to turn them over. Now, I have not sprayed my plants yet this year. I'm getting ready to do it. I've mixed up some in the spray bottle. But see the holes? I know they're there. But at this point, they're very tiny. Ah! You've got to turn the leaves over, and I know this is an extreme close-up and it's blurry, but I'm going to put my thumb in the picture and hopefully you'll see this little darling right by my thumb, if I could get the shade, or the sun to cooperate, sorry. Right here at the end of my finger, do you see that little guy? He's tiny, like a quarter of an inch long, but he's going to get bigger unless I kill him. So that's where you want to kind of spray. You spray on the top, but you can also spray the bottom. And don't wait until you've got huge holes all over your leaves, because that's going to damage your plants. So get out there and do a little spraying early on, and that'll solve your problem. And I mix up, every product's a little different, but I mix up with this particular product about a teaspoon and a quart. And it's really icky, pea green looking stuff, but it works. And so that's what I'm going to do now, and hopefully I can stop leaving that same comment on everybody's channel about what to use. And yes, I've got a weed out here. I have a weekend off. It's supposed to be nice. We've been getting a lot of rain. And I'm going to catch this weedy garden up if it's the last thing I do, and get my tomatoes staked up. And speaking of pests, the only problem I'm having a little bit of a deer problem. Our fence was a little bit crooked, plus they left their calling cards right in there. And they managed to snip off a few tops of the beans down here. Help themselves. But the other pest I'm having, I've got some potato bugs. Never had potato bugs before. And I've been out here, I was out here yesterday just pinching the crap out of them. They squirt all over. Oh, here's one. There's a couple. Oh, I gotta get out here and do it again. I've seen a whole bunch. But see how the leaves are getting eaten up? They will just wipe you out. There's a little one. See him? Bye-bye. Yeah, they're really disgusting. I'm probably disgusting squishing them with my bare hands, but I don't care. They're eating my plants. And they're soft-bodied. Ugh. Yeah, I don't like worms, but yeah, I'll squish these. Go figure. My potatoes, by the way, are just about ready to flower. Probably see that. I'm just going to keep squishing. And that seems to be one of the best ways to get rid of these. You know, if you want to try to be organic. I'm not a purist when it comes to organic gardening. But I do like simple solutions, and squashing bugs is pretty simple to me. They seem to be concentrated right down here at this end on these plants right here. I haven't found them anywhere else. I probably will eventually if I don't get on top of it. But Oh, they're disgusting. I squirted myself in the eye with one the other day. Yuck. I think I kind of caught this before it got too far along, but it's going to take some diligent squishing every day, I think, to keep up with it. Oh, there's a blossom. See? Okay, so if anybody knows a solution, I don't have wood ashes right now. I know, Ken, you put wood ashes on yours. We're not burning anything in the fireplace, and we've long taken care of our ashes from this winter in the compost pile, so I don't have access to that. But if anybody knows of any other solutions besides squishing, let me know. Oh, I was walking down the aisle, and I just answered my own question. I see an adult. I looked up online what they look like. This is an adult potato bug. There's mama or daddy. Aren't they beautiful? Sound effects on that one. Yeah. That's the first adult I've seen. Hopefully that's the grandmother. Or the matriarch, and I got them all. That's one squished from yesterday. Not the double squished one. Anyway, okay, that's all.